Hey, what's going on, everybody? It is me, Attorney Hattie Harp, and this is another edition of Estate Plan Chat. Today, I want to talk about something that's critically important for every parent, and that is nominating guardians for your children. And the way I'm going to sort of entertain the idea is explain to you what happens if you don't nominate guardians for your children, okay? What's going to happen if they need a long-term guardian because of your absence? Maybe you're in the hospital long-term, maybe you develop a disability where you can't take care of them, or in the tragic event that you pass away before they reach the age of 18, they're going to need a guardian to make their legal decisions, take care of them, buy them stuff, make sure they're going to school, and all that good stuff. Essentially, they're going to need someone to step into your shoes and serve as a surrogate parent. And so if you don't make the nomination for who you want to step into those shoes, then you're leaving the choice up to a judge in probate court. Now, don't get me wrong. Judges are great people. They have good intention. They want to make the best decision for whoever's in front of them. In this case, your kids. But unfortunately, they simply don't have all the information necessary to make the best determination. That's because they don't know how you want your kids raised. They don't know what values are important to you, whether that's education, religion, mannerisms, all that good stuff is up to you when you're raising your child. And so when you have someone else stepping into those shoes, a judge is really not going to know who may be the best candidate. You could have someone who's really great on paper, okay, with a great job and a career. They've got kids or they're married, and they've got a nice house. So to a judge, that seems like a safe bet because on paper, they seem like the correct people to raise your kids. But deep down, you may know that someone else may be more important because that person who's great on paper is always at work or raises their children with different values than you would want. And so unfortunately, what ends up happening is your kids could be raised by someone who you didn't want raising them if you don't make a nomination. So you should make a nomination, even in the remote chance that something goes wrong. You want to have that peace of mind and that security. And you can typically make those nominations in your will, okay? And you can also make those nominations in a separate document outside of your will so that, in case it needs to be used without actually probating your will, you've got that separate paper. Or maybe you're not ready or don't want to think about how to develop your will. You could always make a separate guardianship nomination for your kids that you can have available if the time comes for it to be used. Okay, so that's today's video. I hope you learned something. If you want to talk about guardianship for your children or anything related to your estate plan, as always, visit estateplanchat.com and get on my schedule. Thank you. I appreciate you, and I will talk to you next time.